Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel, and today we are going to solve birthday cake candle decorating problem. So this is the problem description. You are in charge of the cake for your niece's birthday and have decided the cake will have one candle for each year of her total age. When she blows out the candle, she will only be able to blow out the tallest one. Your task is to find out how many candles she can successfully blow out. So guys, let me summarize this problem in a short. We have given an array which contains the height of the candles, and the niece can blow out only the candles which is having the maximum height. So let's see this example. If your niece is turning 4 years old and the cake will have 4 candles of height 4, 4, 1 and 3. And she will be able to blow out 2 candles. Like I said, if you have different heights of a candle, but she will be only able to blow out the candles with the maximum height. So you can see the maximum height in this array is 4, and we have 4 twice, means we have 2 candles. So if we have 2 candles with the maximum height, so she can only blow out the 2 candles, which is the answer. So this is the problem guys. Let's see the input format. So input, the first line contains a single integer n denoting the number of candles on the cake, and the second line contains n space separate integer where each integer I describes the height of the candle. So you can see guys, here 4 represent the number of candles present in the array, and these are the 4 candles which is having different heights, and our job is to find out how many candles she can blow out. As we have gone through the problem, we know she can blow out the candles which have maximum height. So in this array we have maximum height is 3, and that maximum height is present 2 times, or you can say we have 2 candles which is having the maximum height, so she can only blow out the 2 candles. I hope guys this problem is clear. Now try to build the logic around it. Let's assume we have an array of size 5 candles, and these are the 5 candles. So our task is to identify how many candles she can blow out. As you know, we have discussed she can blow out only the candles which is having the maximum height. So you can see the maximum height is 4 in this array, and we have 2 candles which is having height 4. So she can only blow out 2 candles. But how did we find that? So the algorithm will be something like this. Step 1, find the maximum from the array. So what we have done? We have found the maximum from the array. And the second step, count the frequency of maximum element. So what we have done guys? We have just taken a maximum element from this array, which is 4, and count the occurrence or frequency of 4 inside the array. So you can see we have 2 occurrences of 4. So that's why the answer is 2. So the algorithm is very sweet and simple guys. So we have to do 2 things here. We have to just find the maximum element from the array, and after that we have to count the number of occurrence of that element. So finding the maximum element from the array requires a for loop, which in that we have to go through all the elements and we can find the maximum. In the same way, counting the frequency of a particular element also requires a for loop, so in that we can count the frequency. As we know, for counting the maximum we apply this logic. We have array. If array element is greater than maximum, so the maximum will be the array element. So this is the logic we always use to get the maximum element from the array, which will be inside a one for loop, and to count the frequency of maximum we have to use if array element is equals to max element. So we have to increase the frequency count. So guys, to find out the maximum in a loop, we have to apply a logic something like this, which will get the maximum value from the array. And the second loop, we have to apply a logic similar to this, which will just check how many frequency or occurrences are there in an array. And if you don't want to write separate loop for these tasks, we can club these 2 tasks in a one for loop and solve this problem. Let's see the algorithm in action, guys. So here we have a method called birthday cake candles, and we are accepting input as an array, and we have taken two variable here. One will maintain the maximum candle height, and the second will maintain the frequency count of the maximum candle height. So guys, this is the for loop where we are traversing throughout the array, and we have applied the same condition which I have shown you earlier. So if the current element is equals to the maximum candle height, so we are assuming the maximum candle height initially will be the minimum value, but if we found current value which is equals to the maximum candle height, we'll just increment the max candle frequency count. Or you can see we are just increment the frequency count of the maximum candle height, and at the same time we are also keep on checking whether current array element is greater than the maximum candle height. Means the current element is having the height which is greater than the maximum candle height so far. If this is the case, it's true we are just swapping the maximum candle height and assigning maximum candle frequency count to 1, because this is the first time we got this element or candle which is having the maximum height. So here we are assigning to 1 because this is the first time we got this candle with the maximum height, and from the next time if we found the same candle, we are just incrementing this maximum frequency count. So once the loop got over, we are returning maximum candle frequency count. Guys, if you have any kind of confusion or doubt how this is happening inside our loop, I will suggest you to create two for loop and one for loop just for finding the maximum height, where you will have this logic, and another loop once you get this is the element which is having our maximum height, you can just traverse through for loop and return the frequency count of that element, or you can say the maximum height of candle. I hope guys that is clear to you. Now just try to run this algorithm on a HackerRank platform. So guys, here I am just directly submitting my code because I know it will work, as I have already solved this earlier. Congratulations. So you can see guys, all test cases got passed. I hope this problem is clear to you guys. How did we solve this problem? Guys, if you want the source code of this problem, you can go to my GitHub repository, and the link is mentioned in the description box. Please don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe, friends, and let me know if you have any better solution for this problem. Thanks for watching guys.